time too.
Both you and Robin?
Me and Robin.
Okay.
We sat there, we were the first shift. Robin's, we have a logbook that we keep. Robin's is filling out the logbook. When Robin gets done filling out his portion of the logbook, he turns the logbook and gives it to me.
The logbook?
Yes, the logbook.
Okay.
As I'm filling out the logbook, the phone rings. Robin's answer the phone.
Do you know who's on the other end of the phone?
No, I don't.
Okay, go ahead.
He answers the phone, hangs the phone up. Then he says, oh, they just called and said somebody
else. Objection, Your Honor, hearsay.
I'll rephrase, Judge.
Yeah, give a phrase, please.
Did you later learn who had called in on that phone?
Yes.
And who had called in on that phone?
It was a tower.
And do you know the purpose of the tower calling, making that call?
Because the tower looked down and said they seen an inmate in the courtyard smoking.
And did you later learn that they made Robbins aware of that?
Yes.
In response to that phone call, what, if anything, did Robbins do?
Robbins got up and started going outside.
Okay.
I'm finishing up writing the book. I get up, start walking towards the door.
Mm-hmm.
I see Robbins bringing the inmate inside the unit.
Okay.
Robbins tells me that this is the one that was out there smoking.
Okay. Now, stop there for a minute.
Yes.
You were on your feet.
Yes.
And Robbins was bringing Small in, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, and informs you he's out there smoking.
Yes.
Okay. What did you do?
From that moment,
he's telling you that, what did you do next?
I told him he put his hands up against the wall.
And that would have been Small?
Yes.
Okay. Well, you heard Small testify, and they didn't say you did that. But is that what you did?
Yes.
Okay. And what did you do? Did you search him?
No. Robbins searched him.
Okay. Why didn't you search him? Why Robbins instead of you?
Robbins already had the gloves on.
Okay. So, Robbins had the gloves on, and he searched him. And then, what, if anything, did you do next?
When Robin searched him and went in his pocket and pulled out, I guess, whatever they were wrapped up in, and Robin's had them, and he put them on the desk. All the other inmates that was in the day room, I proceeded to tell them to get up, go down to the bus.
Clear it out the day room.
Clear it out the day room.
Why?
Because we're going to put Smalls in there.
Did Small eventually go in the day room?
Yes, he did.
Who took him in the day room?
I took him in the day room.
And what did you do once he was in the day room?
I told Robin to call the sergeant.
Okay. Now, you're working on 6th unit that day.
Yes.
And this event occurred. Were you required to write any kind of a report?
Yes.
What was the type of report you were required to write?
Just a report stating of what happened.
Is that the general practice inside the prison? If something occurs, you write a report?
Practice, that's the practice. If something happens, you have to write a report.
Is there any exception to that practice?
There's no exception.
So you wrote a report?
Yes.
Robbins wrote a report?
Yes.
Are they called special reports?
Yes.
When you wrote the report, what then did you do with it?
We gave it to the sergeant.
What sergeant?
The sergeant that was on that day.
Recall his name?
I'm Sergeant Norton.
Was Sergeant Norton working in the 6th unit? Or was he in some other location?
He was in another location. Robbins had called him over the radio to call 6th unit. When the sergeant called, Robbins said, we had something. Can you report to 6th unit?
So you wrote a special report that day?
Yes.
And it detailed your involvement in that case and what you saw?
Yes.
Okay. Now, during the time you worked in Unit 6 or 6th Unit, was anyone, to your knowledge, ever caught with contraband? Any inmate ever caught with contraband while you worked there?
Yes.
while you were, who, was there ever an instance where you located some kind of contraband, and seized it?
Protection out of relevance? Or maybe it's just too vague?
Do you understand the question, Mr. Saunders? I'll rephrase it. Was there an occasion where you reported the discovery of illegal drugs in Unit 6?
Yes, it was in Unit 6.
Okay. Where was it?
It was in the female's bathroom.
In the visiting area?
Yes, in the visiting area.
Did you work in the visiting area from time to time?
No.
How is it you discovered contraband in the woman's bathroom?
Inmate told me.
When the inmate told you that, did you go to the bathroom?
No.
Do you know where the contraband was? What? Your supervisor was advised, is that correct?
Yes.
Who told
you? I told him.
Do you know where the contraband was discovered?
They discovered in a light socket. I guess it's like a plate that covers the light socket.
Mm-hmm.
Was discovered.
The switch, lights were going off?
Yes.
And it was discovered behind there?
Yes.
Did you have to write a report, a special report in connection with that event?
No, I did not write a report.
Why didn't you, generally, if that is the practice, why did you not write a report on that occasion?
When the inmate told me about it, he told me about it on a Tuesday. And he stated that on visits, this is where they put the drugs at. The females put the drugs in that light socket.
Do you know about when that was? The inmate told you that?
That was like June. That was like June 2017.
Okay. And you then explained that to your supervisor?
Yes.
And some staff member then located the CDS, is that correct?
Yes.
Do you know what it, when I say CDS, drugs,
yes.
Someone located that?
Yes.
Do you know what kind of drug it was?
It was tobacco, Suboxone.
Okay. So did you caution or tell the inmate to be quiet about it, not tell anybody because units could get tossed? Did you tell that to the inmate?
No.
Is it correct that the first thing you did was notify your supervisor?
Yes.
Were you or anyone else ever able to discover who was responsible for putting the contraband in the lady's bathroom?
Nothing.
Do you have an idea what was the plan for that contraband in the lady's bathroom? Someone going to go in and get it? You know.
Objection calls for speculation.
But have you learned since then what was the plan for retrieving that contraband out of the woman's bag?
Yes.
What was the plan?
The plan was we had a porter on our unit. Mm-hmm. It was a gym porter. The gym porter's responsibility was to go down to the gym after visits and clean up the visit area.
Well, you said we had a gym porter from Unit 6?
Well, from all units.
Okay.
All units had gym porters.
Okay.
The porter was to go down. One of the areas that he cleaned was a woman's bathroom.
Okay.
The gym porter was to go down, retrieve the drugs, and bring them back to the unit.
Okay. That was the plan amongst the folks?
Yes.
The inmates. Did you have anything to do with the drugs coming in that woman's bathroom?
No.
Now, the Cobian Shepherd, Tasha Swain, what, if anything, did you know about the connection between those two individuals?
No connection.
You didn't know about that?
No connection.
Did Tasha ever tell you about the connection with the Cobian?
No.
Now, on the 20th of November, 2017, we understand from the testimony of various witnesses that you met with Ms. Swain in the ShopRite parking lot tomorrow. Is that correct?
Yes.
You did meet with her, did you not?
Yes.
Who got there first, you or her?
She was there first.
When you pulled in, and you were meeting her for what purpose?
To give my money that she owed.
Okay. So when you pulled in, on which side of her car did you pull? Driver's side or the passenger side?
I pulled in on the passenger, I mean the driver's side.
Okay. Did you get out of your car?
No, I did not.
At any point while you were there, did you open your trunk?
No.
Did you have an automatic opener for your trunk?
Yes.
Did you by chance push it?
No.
You never got out of your car?
Never got out of my car.
When you were there and you were parked, did you go over to her car or did she come to your car? What happened?
When I parked, the next thing I know, she was coming over to my car.
Which side of the car did she come from?
She came from the driver's side.
Okay. Did you have your window up or down?
My window was down.
And what happened when she came over to your window?
She came over to my window. She came over, gave me a bag, said, enjoy the trip.
Did she hand you some money in addition to giving you the bag?
Nah, just gave me a bag.
And what was in the bag? Let me withdraw it. Was there an exchange of money? Did she give you money? Was there money in the bag?
Yeah, it was money in the bag.
Did she give you money in your hand or just the money in the bag?
Just the money in the bag.
Okay. And she said, enjoy your trip.
Enjoy my trip.
Did she leave pretty quickly?
Yes.
Who left first, drove away first, you or her?
She drove away first.
And then you left out of the parking lot after she did?
Yes.
And we understand that you were stopped, at some point you were stopped by police?
Yes.
Now, you saw some of the officers testify here. Did any of the officers who testified here, were they involved in stopping you?
Yes.
Who was that? Inglehart?
Yes.
Okay. Now, what, if anything, was said what after they stopped you?
They pulled me over.
Was it uniform car?
No, it wasn't a uniform
car. Okay. You got pulled over.
Yes.
Did you pull over right away?
Yes.
Okay, and what happened next?
Detective Inglehart came up to my window. He asked me, you Saunders? I said, yeah. Told me, car park. To get out the car. For what?
He said, asked him for what?
Yes.
Okay. So what happened next?
And he said, get out the car, put it in park.
Okay. Then what happened?
I put it in park.
Did you get out of the car?
Yes.
When you got out of the car, did he search you?
Yes.
Now, did he tell you to put your hands on the car, or how did you go about searching?
He got me out of the car, he walked me around from the driver's side to the passenger side.
Okay. Did he have you put your hands on the car?
Yes, I don't put my hands on the car.
Did he search you?
Yes.
And when he searched you, did he find something on you?
He found a weed on me.
Now, you heard his testimony. He said that you had concealed some type of contraband in your crotch. Is that correct?
It was in my sweatpants.
Explain.
When they pulled me over, mm-hmm. and took the weed and put it in the on the side of my sweatpants.
Okay.
On the side of my sweatpants.
Why'd you do that?
I didn't know who was pulling through. I just know the police officers.
You didn't want them to discover the weed.
Yeah, we didn't want them to discover
it. It was illegal possession.
Yes.
Okay. So the officer stops you and he searches you. And how is it that he located the weed?
As he was searching me, he tells me, oh, he's like, I smell weed. Mm-hmm. So as he's searching me, when he get near my pants area, it's like a twisting motion. Like, take my pants, twisting my pants, whatever. And at that time, the weed that was on the side of me fell down my pants. down towards the bottom of my ankles.
Did, on your sweatpants, did he ever reach down the front of your sweatpants in your crotch area?
No, he did not.
And I understand, stand up if you would just generally show your pants how he did that.
He came, he had his, he came and started patting me down, and he said, I smell weed, so he took my pants and he started shaking it like that.
And the weed fell down?
And the weed fell down.
Okay, he picked it up off the ground?
Excuse me?
And he picked it up off the ground after
nah,
that?
Nah, it was still, I had a last day. Was last stick at the bottom, so it didn't go straight down.
Okay.
So he patted down, he felt the package, and he reached in. That's right.
Okay. Now, backing up a few minutes to your encounter with Ms. Swain, did she give you any tobacco?
No.
Now, you've read the reports in this case and so forth.
Yes.
Did you see any report where it was reported that tobacco was discovered in your car when they stopped you?
No.
There was no tobacco in your car?
There was tobacco on my car.
Now, when Ms. Swain came over to your car on the driver's side at the window, did she lean into your car?
She didn't lean into my car. She just stood at my car, stood up against my car.
Did she have her hands on the windowsill of the car?
Yeah. Yeah, like, she stood in my car and had her hands, like, on the sill of the car.
Okay.
On the sill of the car.
Did she have anything in her hands when she was doing that?
She had a bag.
And did she hand you the bag?
Or yeah, she dropped it. My hand was here and she just dropped it back in my hand.
Right. What did you think was in the bag?
Money.
Did you think anything else was in the bag besides money?
No.
You got weed from her and you kept the weed. Did you think weed was in the bag?
No. I didn't know about the weed until when I started driving off and then I smelled it.
Mm-hmm. How much money was in the bag that she gave you?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? Tell, why don't you know?
I didn't count.
Okay. Well, did you later learn, were you able to discern how much money she had actually given you?
Yes.
Well, when you stopped or stopped by the police, you had money on you, correct?
Yes.
And they took the money from you,
yes.
Is that correct? And they also took the money Ms. Swain had given you, is that correct?
Yes.
And it was all put together?
Yes.
And it was taken from you, correct?
Yes.
And you later learned how much money they had taken from you and the denominations, correct?
Yes.
And were you able then to figure out how much she gave you?
Yes.
And I understand you didn't count the money that she gave to you, but you were able to figure out what she gave you.
Yes.
So they took from you, I understand, $2,100?
$2,166.
Okay. Where did, tell us where that money came from, the money they took from you.
The money they took from me was $1,000. Well, $1,000 of it that my brother gave me. Mm-hmm. $1,000 that to marry you.
How much did your brother give you?
He gave me $1,200 altogether.
Okay. Did you spend any of that?
Yes.
How much of it did you spend?
I'm not really quite sure.
Okay. More than $300?
Maybe around $200-something. Maybe close to $2,200.
So maybe $1,000 left from what your brother
gave. Yes.
$1,000 from Tamara. And so how were you able to tell how much she gave
you? He added up. It was $160 that she gave.
And that, what was that money for that she had given you?
That was for the money that she had owed.
Now,
I have my own $6.
You gotta wait for the question.
Okay,
you did have some money yourself, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. And are you sure to the penny how much she gave you, or are you giving us an approximation?
Sure how much she gave you.
Okay. Based on knowing what you had.
Yes.
Okay. Now, Mr. Saunders, you're here testifying, and your testimony, some might think, seems convenient. But I'll draw your attention to the point in time where you were being interviewed by the police. And it's my recollection that you said during that statement that you asked the police to show you your phone, you could shed some light on all of this,
yes.
Correct? Did you ever get a chance to show them what was on your phone?
No.
What did you mean that you could shed some light on all of this? What did you mean?
I just showed where the money came from.
How is your phone going to help you do that?
I had a picture on my phone, taking the money that was in my pocket. $1,000 of money that was in my pocket.
So you could have shown them a picture that somehow would have explained to them where $1,000 of the money came from?
Yes.
When did you take that picture?
I took that picture earlier in the day.
On the 20th?
Yes.
What exactly did you take a picture of?
The money that Tamara had given me, I took a picture. I took a picture of it.
Okay. Is that all you took a picture of?
No, I took a picture of the money in the car.
So, do I understand that you were asking the police to allow you to access your phone so you could show them the picture of the money and the car Tamara gave you?
Yes.
On your phone, if the police allowed you to do that, would there have been any way on your phone that you could have shown them the date and time that picture was taken?
Yes.
Why did you take a picture of the money that day? And you said the card and the money. Why did you take that picture?
Because I sent it to a friend of mine who's a co-worker.
Another correctional officer?
Yes.
So you get money from Tamara and you're going to send a picture of it to a co-worker?
Yes.
I mean, I'm not sure I would have done that. So why'd you do that?
With the text message, it read...
What text message? You sent a text message?
Yes.
Okay. So go ahead. Explain.
Text message read, went to lunch with my friend. This is what she did for me. Gave me $1,000 for my trip. And my broken windshield.
That was the text message you sent with the picture to your
yes.
friend. To what friend did you send that? Co-worker's name.
Her name is Dorm Pierce.
Now, if you would have been able to access your phone, you would have been able to show that to the police
yes.
that day?
Yes.
Did you offer to get consent for them to access the phone?
Several times.
And did they decline to access your phone?
Yes.
What did they say? Why did they not look at it?
They just said no.
You heard the testimony when your brother testified that you never mentioned that he had given you money that day. Is that correct?
Yes.
Why did you not mention that?
Because the money they asked me about was $1,000. And when they had put them in my pocket, $1,000, I had a rubber band. And when they asked me about that money, that $1,000, that's the $1,000 that Tamara had gave me. And that's what I was trying to show them on the phone.
Well, Mr. Saunders, is it accurate that your brother did give you $1,200 a day as he
yes.
kept something? Did you ask your brother to lie for you?
No.
Now, how many times that day do you recall? How many times did you ask the police if you could access your phone? Do you recall?
three times.
And you did explain to them in that request that it would shed some light on things, correct?
Yes.
Did they ever ask you what you meant by the comment, it would shed some light?
No.